Hey, what's going on? Thanks for clicking on this video. Hope you stayed through its entirety. I had a chance to sit down with Samantha on the internet, you know, she's known as SARKAZZ. I've been following her on YouTube, Instagram. So I got a minute, you know, to sit down and talk with her. Thank you for, you know, taking the time to sit down and talk to me. You know, I got my questions, you know. No problem. Thanks for having me. And yeah, I'm looking forward to this dialogue. Like I said, I've been following you for a minute. But I've seen your IG posts lately, and while they hold a lot of truths, they kind of hold some hurt. Tell me about that. Oh, I'm assuming you're talking about, like, being gay is not a struggle. Navigating life, being gay is a struggle. Just that, for example. I'm just kind of been tired. Of my life being seen as a struggle. You know, it's not even asked what exactly is my struggle, what exactly the things I'm dealing with, but it's just taken as being gay is a struggle, when it's not. It's navigating everything else while being gay. And I'm tired of, you know, to me, that whole thought process comes, I know it from the church, you know, and here we go, a place that doesn't welcome us, doesn't, you know, sit down and have real conversations with us, but they want to tell us who we are, what we are, who we should be, who we should not be. Fuck out of here. So that was that, you know, that's basically what that post was about. I don't remember what year it was, but the church that I, you know, was raised in, they so-called had some open forum, which wasn't open, no kind of dialogue. It's, oh God. Again, I have a problem with a place that does not talk to you, does not see where you are, but they want to tell you who to be and how to be. Again, get the fuck out of here. So, yeah. And yeah, you do sense hurt in there. It's not what it used to. I wouldn't even really say it's hurt. I guess it's just really like disappointed. Like, damn, we still having the same conversation. I'm 44. And, you know, the whole thing that happened, you know, with me coming into knowing who I am happened when I was like in my early 20s. And I'm like, why is this still a thing? Like, my thing, worry about your soul salvation, like, just love, like, why is it such a concern about who I'm loving, who I'm marrying, me adopting? What the hell does it have to do with your soul salvation? When you get to heaven, is God going to say, how many gays did you bring to me and transform? So it's not really hurt anymore. It's just I'm disappointed and I'm fed up and I'm tired. And so I'm going to start being a little bit more vocal about it. Yeah. So that's what you get. That's what you're sensing in my posts recently. And I want, you know, not so much the generation now, because the generation now, the LGBT is fierce. I wish I had all of that back then. Because I think things would have been a little bit different for me. But in my age, I'm 44, in my age group and the generation that came right after, we still struggling with the issue, you know, with the church and religion and, you know, the black community, you know, period. It's a little bit different than the generation today. So I think, like, some of the stuff that I feel people my age, and again, this generation just after that, can kind of understand where I'm coming from. Not to say the generation now don't understand, but the generation today is like, really don't give a fuck. And I love it. I've heard you made fun of the, kind of make just as a joke. I mean, you in the community, I mean, I guess you can. You know, LGBTQI, it's a lot. But do you think God loves the LGBTQI community? Yes, I do. Without a doubt, I know he loves us. He loves everybody. But I would say that I think he loves us just a little bit more. I'm just saying, because we need it. You know, it's like, I didn't know what a relationship with God was until I went through through what I went through at the church I grew up in. I didn't know what relationship was. Yeah, I've heard about it, but I didn't know what it was. Because when you are alone, you really realize what and who God is. In a post that I made on my page, I'm telling you, it's a little hurt still, because it's like, it sucks to still be having this conversation. When I was sat down, removed from everything in the church, all I had was God. I didn't have my family, because they, you know, they didn't know what I was going through, because they are part of the church and that whole system. So going through the shit alone, it was hard. And if it wasn't for God and the relationship that I had, I would have committed suicide. I've had bad thoughts about it. Because imagine being in a place where you grew up, where you believe this was family. This is unity. What they say when it's good for brethren to fellowship together, you know, when you come in unity, to know that it's really not unity. It's a tough pill to swallow. And being so young and not knowing anything but that, it's very difficult. So yeah, if I didn't have a relationship, fuck church, fuck religion, fuck the four walls. God is everywhere. If I didn't know him for myself, if I didn't come and build that relationship, I wouldn't be here today. And it just hurts that the conversation is still, and it's not the right conversation. Because, I'm sorry. I'm a little bit angry. Because again, why are we still having this conversation? And it's the wrong conversation. And when I say it's the wrong conversation, you know, the other day there was a post. You know, I follow Kevin on stage. I'm sure a lot of people have seen it by now. There was a post. And my thing is, before I get into that, I've said it before, everyone has an opinion. It's great. But in having your opinion, you got to respect others' opinions. And I take that to, in people having a journey, you got to respect everybody's journey. And you have to want to hear everyone's journey. Now, I'll briefly speak about it. I'll put a link down below. You can, you know, go and watch the video in its entirety and everything. Now, I had no problem with this woman's testimony. But what I have a problem with, it was just one-sided. So my thing is, if you're going to have a dialogue about you used to be a lesbian and now you are heterosexually function, you need to have somebody else on that panel talking about the reality of, guess what? Not everybody is going to, that's not everyone's testimony and journey. So here we go, you have, you know, the person, you know, Kevin State has a big platform. Here you go, putting this out there during Pride Month. You know, try to like reinforce, like, yeah, you can change. You don't gotta be gay, da 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 da. That is not everyone's journey. And this is, you know, and I was having a discussion with a friend of mine, and you know, again, everyone had their opinion. Live and let live. It is a detrimental thing to have a conversation like that and not have other points of view. Because that, what that video did was just fuel what the church has been doing to us. Oh, it's just a phase. It's just that. Ba-da-da-da. You can change. You can da-da-da. It's problematic. So you love Jesus, but dislike the church and religion? Tell me about that. Yeah, I love Jesus. And hate is a strong word. I don't like the church and religion, because the same things that was put on us to get us in line and do what the master says is the same thing that the black community, the black church, is doing to the gay community. You don't need a degree to see it. It's the same thing that's being done. Now, while, okay, yes, we're going through everything, you know, Black Lives Matter movement, blah, blah, blah. I get it. I'm all for it. But the thing is, I'm black. I'm a black woman and I'm a black gay woman. That's three things. Guess what? They don't separate. So I have to deal with them all at once. All at once. You know, it's a sad thing to say you don't feel safe in your community. And I'm talking about family, church, and the world. It's not a good feeling. And it sucks to be 44 and still having this conversation. And it's the wrong ones we're having. I don't give a fuck about acceptance. If I'm a person and I don't eat beef, I'm gonna be mad you eat beef. Eat beef, what the shit got to do with me? It ain't clogging up my arteries. The fuck? It's a matter of respect and love. That's it. That's it. It's just always, it's like, it's just weird. Why the fuck are you so concerned about the life? Like, how is it affecting yours? So yeah, I'm not with the religion and church, no. Because of what it's taught me is that if you're not in this one space, you're not welcomed. You're not welcomed. Imagine being young, coming in to understand, trying to understand your sexuality. And the place where you turn to is supposed to be refuge, turns you away. You can't go to your family because they're part of that place that where you want to go to for refuge and has turned you away. So what the fuck do you do? But you want to, you know, jump on the bandwagon when someone comes and, oh, puts out something talking about, oh, you can get, you know, use myself as example as a woman. You can marry a man, you know, you may still have the feelings, but marry the man, have the children, be fruitful and multiply, because that's what God said to do. That's what God wants you to do. The devil is a liar. What it is, so a man thinketh, so is he. So then, okay, here I'm being, okay, I'm a lesbian. Okay, Jesus, I'm going to go marry a man. But yet I want to be with a, you know, but yet I want to be with, you know, I have feelings for a woman. But I'm going to be with this man because that's the Lord. You're going to be fruitful. You're going to multiply. Da-da-da-da. So a man thinketh, so is he. So I'm bisexual. Call it what it is. But not even that can people do. Call it what it is. Call it what it is. Stop diminishing our lives. You know, being gay is okay if you don't say anything. We lead the choirs, write the wonderful music, direct, sing, lead, and praise and worship, but don't say anything. We may think it, but don't say it. Don't confirm it. Yeah. So I love Jesus, but I hate the church. Okay, I said it's a strong word, but it's how I really... how it really feels coming out. I hate the church and I hate religion. Because the same things, you know, again, like I said, I'm a black woman, I'm a black gay woman. The same thing that, you know, the white man took this and got us in line, it's the same shit you're doing to your own people. Check it. It's the same shit you're doing. Yeah.
You know, we've talked off camera and, you know, I like that you're very passionate about things that you've experienced and things you want to share. And so my question is, why does the word struggle when put towards homosexuality get under your skin so much?
Why does the word struggle get to me when they put with homosexuality? Because again, that's something from the church. Who the fuck said I'm struggling? And anyone that knows me, I'm an English major. I have a thing for words. You know, people don't like that. Oh, well, get a dictionary. Alonzo Lerone. Yeah. Struggle. The definition of struggle is make forceful or violent efforts to get free of restraint or constriction. You heard that? That's the verb. The noun, a forceful or violent effort to get free of, restraint, or resist attack. I ain't struggling being gay. There's nothing restraining me or constricting me. The noun is a forceful or violent effort to get free or restraint or restrict attack. Resist attack, excuse me. Again, I'm not restrained and I'm not being attacked by homosexuals. Oh, there's no gay agenda. No one turned me gay. No, I wasn't raped. No, I wasn't raped. It is what it is. And I have a problem again with people who don't talk to us, who don't ask us about our experiences, who are not in the struggle with us, in the struggle, not being gay, in the struggle meaning fighting all this bullshit. But you want to hear put the word struggle on who I am? Who the fuck told you I'm struggling with who I am? That's what you want to believe that. So that's something that, oh, okay. Oh, you struggling with this. Come to the Lord and leave your burdens there. Who said being gay is a burden? All the religious bullshit is the burden. That's the burden. Imagine being in a place where, again, refuge. And you can't get it. So yeah, fuck religion and fuck the church. I'm good with Jesus. Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, this has been awesome. Like I said, thanks again for taking time to sit and talk with me.
Oh, no, I should say, to whoever's watching this, if you're struggling with religion and who you are, just know that Jesus is enough. Whoever you believe in is enough, because not everyone believes in, you know, there's different religions. Whoever you believe in is enough. Build a relationship with that higher being. Pray. Pray fasting. All them things. I ain't against all of that. But again, get your own relationship. Be strong. Because religion and church will fuck you up. Yeah. So that's all I got to say.
I hope some of, you know, what has been said here today helps somebody. And also helps you in still dealing with the matters of the LGBTQIA community and church and religion and all of that. I really appreciate the time, and hopefully we can do this again. All right.